Hello everyone, I hope you all are fine. Welcome to our English class. So my dear children, in the last session we have studied the story Tiger's Stripes. All right, so today we will discuss some questions about it. Okay, and we will also solve all the question and answers which are mentioned in your English textbook. So for this you will need to open your English textbook part 1. Which book? English textbook part 1. Please open your textbook to page number 2, Tiger's Stripes. After opening this you have to read the A sound words, I sound words and E sound words given here. After that you have to read the story again. All right, now open your page number 4. Here let us discuss part is mentioned. So let us discuss about it. I have already written the questions on board. Now our first question is, what made the tiger angry? Now as you have already studied the story that there was a tiger who was very angry. He had a tiger cub whose name was Tiggy, right? And that Tiggy was trying to solve the problem. Okay, so let us discuss now why the tiger was angry. So I have already asked about this, right? That why the tiger was angry. The tiger was angry because his stripes were missing, right? Now all the animals were scared of him. Why? Because he was shouting on everyone, right? So the answer of this question is that the tiger was angry because of his missing stripes. I will write it down on board for you. So please read the answer as I'm writing it. Tiger was angry because of his missing stripes. Okay. Our next question is, what did the old lady on the hill know? Now, when Tiggy, the cub, when he was trying to solve the problem, he discussed this about his to his friend Bruno, right? And what Bruno suggested him? He suggested him to go on a hill where the old lady stays, right? So what did that old lady on the hill know? Why did Bruno suggested to go on the hill and meet that old lady? Do you know this answer? I'll discuss it to you. Okay, the old lady on the hill knew magic. So now I'll write the answer for you. What did the old lady on the hill know? The old lady on the hill knew magic. Okay, now let's move towards the literature comprehension, that is exercise number 2. Literature comprehension means what? You will know about the questions which are related to the story. Okay, you will have to answer that questions as well as write it down in your content book. Exercise number 2, literature comprehension, which is on page number 4. The question is, what did Bruno ask Tiggy to do? Now, just before this, we have already answered this question. Okay. Now, when Tiggy wanted to help his father, right? What he did? He went to his friend Bruno and he asked Bruno that I wanted to help my father. So, what can I do to help him? So, Bruno suggested him something. What did he suggest? It is already mentioned in your previous question that Bruno suggested him to go and meet the old lady who knows magic. And where does the old lady stay? The old lady stay on the hills. Okay. Now let us write the answer. Bruno asked Tiggy to meet the old lady. Why did Bruno suggest Tiggy to go and meet old lady? Because the lady knew magic. So she can help Tiggy to bring his father's stripes back with the help of magic. Now let us move towards our second question. What did the old lady say when Tiggy knocked the door? Now when Tiggy reached at the old lady's home, what he did? He knocked the door. Okay. And after that, there was a response from that old lady. So what response did the lady give? Did she directly help Tiggy? No, she didn't directly help Tiggy. What she said first? That I don't want to help you, you go away. What did she told? That I don't want to help you, you go away. Okay. So let us write the answer. What did the old lady say when Tiggy knocked the door? The old lady told Tiggy to go away. Okay? So she told Tiggy to go away. Next question is, what melted the old lady's heart? Now when the old lady said Tiggy to go away, what did she do? What did Tiggy do? Did he go away? No. What was his aim? His aim was to help his father, right? So what he did? He started crying that please help me, and he started requesting the old lady that ma'am, please help me, I wanted to help my father, right? So what melted the old lady's heart when she became ready to help Tiggy? When he started crying. So I'll write the answer. Tiggy's big tears melted the old lady's heart. Alright, so Tiggy's big tears melted the old lady's heart. Okay, now if anyone will cry in front of you, like your friend, your family members, then you will also feel pity on them, right? And what will you do? You will help them. The same way when Tiggy cried in front of that old lady, her heart was melted and she became ready to help Tiggy. Okay, and how did she help Tiggy? She gave some magic powder to him, right? So Tiggy sprinkled that magic powder on the tiger's body, and then all his stripes were back again. Okay, now let us move towards our next question. That is, why were all the animals overjoyed in the end? Now what happened at the end of the story? What happened? The tiger's stripes came back. Now did it directly came back? No. What happened then? Tiggy had to struggle a lot to bring his father's stripes back. Now let us move towards the next question. Why were all the animals overjoyed in the end? Now what happened in the end? The tiger's stripes were back again. But do you think this happened so soon? Was it so easy? No, it was not so easy. Tiggy had to struggle a lot just to bring his father's stripes back. Okay, now at the end, all the animals were overjoyed because Tiger's stripes were back, and now he was not angry with any one of them, and there was peace again in the forest. So everybody was overjoyed. Okay, now let's write the answer. All the animals were overjoyed. In the end, because Tiger's stripes were back and there was peace in the forest again. Okay, so what's the answer? All the animals were overjoyed in the end because Tiger's stripes were back and there was peace in the forest again. Alright, now let us move towards exercise number 3, that is value-based questions. Okay, now these value-based questions are to be solved by you. I am not going to write the answers on board. Do you know why? Because I want to see that what you have understood from this story. Okay, but still we will discuss about the answer. Our first question is, was Tiggy a good son? Why do you think so? Now, do you all think that Tiggy was a good son? Has he done anything like that which makes you think so? Do you think, was he good? What he did in the story? He helped his father to bring his stripes back, right? So do you think he is a good son? Alright, so think about this answer and you have to write that. Our next question is, describe the old woman on the hill in your own words. Now, when Tiggy went to meet the old woman who was living on the hills, how was she? When she opened the door, how did Tiggy found her? Was she dressed up very nicely? No, her clothes were tattered, right? She was wearing torn clothes. Okay, now tell me again what you can tell about her. She was old. She was very, very old. And what did she knew? Why Tiggy went on the hill? Because the old lady knew magic. So here we have solved all the exercises. You also have to write all these questions and answers in your textbook. Now tell me, have you ever helped anyone? Who was that person? What was the problem? And how did you feel after solving that problem? Okay, you have to write this answer in your English notebook and send a photograph. Okay, thank you so much.